Entrepreneurs have celebrated people around the world for their ability to solve complex problems in society. There are people who look at an environment or an industry and go like, how could things be better or how could we improve things? While solving problems, they also make money for themselves along the line. On a continent like ours, there are many issues surrounding us in every aspect of life. However, seeing many young entrepreneurs rising and deciding to tackle these problems is probably one of the biggest promises of a better future for Mother Africa. This video is about some of the best young entrepreneurs who are significantly impacting their respective countries and the continent at large. We'll take you on a continental trip to discover these beautiful and brilliant African minds. If this is your first time watching us, make sure you hit the subscribe button and click also on the notification bell to never miss any of our future videos. Now, let's get started. Number 1. Itop Ikpe Otocheck. Who best to start an entrepreneurship video with other than a Nigerian entrepreneur? Itop Ikpe, the CEO of Otocheck, is one of Nigeria's most prolific serial tech founders, having worked for Deal Day, Cars 45, and now Otocheck. In total, he has created so far 5 companies within 15 years. He is probably the African version of Elon Musk, disrupting one industry after the other. He also worked for Konga, the e-commerce giant now owned by Zinox. But before operating these firms, Ikpe served as a co-founder and director of projects for a marketing agency named Click Mobile Communications in 2006. In an interview, he revealed that his experience at Click Mobile has been critical in making him the serial entrepreneur he has become today. He also added that he loves the idea of building great companies. Number 2. Tabiseng Mosia, EasySolar. Mosia was born in Ghana and moved to South Africa later in life. She first became interested in energy after experiencing blackouts as a teenager. This is very common with most successful entrepreneurs. They have usually experienced the problem themselves and know what it feels like to live it. During Mosia's doctoral studies, she and her co-founders came up with the concept of supplying safe and inexpensive power to West African households that were not served by the grid. EasySolar claims to have provided electricity to over 30,000 homes since it was established. That's a considerable achievement, knowing very well how complex electricity access is in Africa. The company intends to extend its operations into neighboring Liberia and Kenya shortly. Mosia is also a champion of African empowerment initiative. She does a lot in public speaking across the continent too. Black girl magic in action. Number 3. Paul Kinyiko, Wing It, Nairobi. Are you ready to wing it? Are you ready to chew it? Are you prepared to go the African way? After meeting Paul Kinyiko, you will change your mind about McDonald's and start chewing more African fast food chicken wings. The idea of Wing It Nairobi came to Paul when he was in a restaurant with some friends, and out of the vast menu of burgers, chips, chickens, everyone on the table decided to go with chicken. At that moment, he realized that he could build a whole new and exciting business about chicken's consumption. Chicken wings have been doing well in Europe and America and could have a good run in Africa. Today, the company has 2 locations and is expanding with 15 different flavors of chicken wings, with which Kinyiko developed by playing with various recipes. If you are following up to this stage, let us know your thoughts about importing Western business concepts to Africa. Do you think we should have more of these businesses? Let us know in the comment section. Number 4. Rama Bajun, M&M Clothing Line. M&M Clothing Line is a successful Afrocentric clothing brand in Tanzania that manufactures inexpensive dresses, wallets, and other fashion accessories for men and women using famous East African kintage fabric. It was founded and managed by Rama Bajun. Clothing is an essential part of life in Africa, whether you live in Kinshasa or Cotonou. The Nigerian firm employs close to 20 full-time workers and exports its goods in East Africa. Bajon was named one of Africa's 30 most ambitious young entrepreneurs by Forbes magazine in 2018. She is also a vibrant youth leader who has been connecting with young people for quite some time in finding ways to address issues facing them through politics and policy involvement and marketing her goods across East Africa. Well done, Bajon. Number 5, Abdella Malik, Sci Labs. One of the biggest challenges in building an excellent entrepreneurship ecosystem in Africa is the lack of sufficient or adequate venture capitalist firms or incubators. That is what Abdella Malik realized in Algeria. Abdella Malik is the owner of Sci Labs, an Algiers-based innovation and entrepreneurship center dedicated to inspiring young Algerians interested in starting their own companies or learning new skills. Over the last 5 years, Sci Labs has aided several small companies in launching or expanding their operations and building a group of thousands of people who share a passion for technology, digital economy, and entrepreneurship. In 2008, Abdella got featured in Forbes Africa's 30 Under 30 list. Number 6, Alisha Jivraj, Royal Electronics. Usually, the field of electronics is left to Americans and Asians. But having an African venture in it and doing well is certainly something interesting to cover. Royal Electronics is a company founded by Ugandan entrepreneur and industrialist Ali Shah Jivraj that assembles electronic products. The company brings out of his factories TV sets, radio, batteries, and other critical electronic gadgets. It was recorded that the company generated $15 million in 2015. He also boasts of a real estate firm developing high-end suburban apartments in two of Kampala's residential area. A hardcore industrialist at work. Should Dangote be worried? If you are still learning something interesting at this stage, drop "still hot" in the comment section. Number 7, Fredigbe, Heal the World. For Fredigbe Jr., Africa deserves to have its own collection of high-end luxury clothing brands. That is what the young Ghanaian entrepreneur is working on. He is currently the co-founder and CEO of the luxury shoe brand Heal the World, a name inspired by both Heal from Heal as in a shoe and Heal the World song by late pop star Michael Jackson. He was a former banker and teamed up with his then school friend in 2011 to take on this bold decision of creating the Zara and Louis Vuitton for Africa. Many successes like features in BBC content and panel sitting with Aliko Dangote at the World Economic Forum have followed the young Ghanaian entrepreneur. All the best, Fred. Number 8, Adenike Ogulesi, Ralph and Tumble. Next on our list comes another fashion-related business, but this time from a much different angle. Adenike Ogulesi is the founder, CEO, and chief designer officer of the Nigerian children's clothing line named Ralph and Tumble. She started her hustle long ago and is the living proof of absolute focus and determination. She started in 1996 by selling pajamas in the boot of a car. From the boot of a car to gaining international recognition, that is an outstanding achievement. Another noticeable thing about her is that she firmly believes that with restricted funds, no access to investors, the stubbornness of purpose will always reign supreme. And that is very true for as long as you are building a venture on a viable business model. We wish you more success, Adeniki. Number 9, Fred Swanika, African Leadership Academy. this Ghanaian entrepreneur has a different view on the central problem hindering the full development of Africa. Fred Swanika's passion and innovation are deeply rooted in the fact that he believes that the missing ingredient in Africa's success is good leadership. From that belief, he built so far four institutions that mainly focus on improving the quality of leadership in Africa. We at Heated Pundit fully believe that there is an important need to improve the leadership in Africa, and that is what motivated us to feature him on this list. Additionally, Fred was part of the young African leaders who visited the US President Barack Obama at the White House first ever President Forum for Young African Leaders in 2010. The World Economic Forum has named him a young global leader, and Forbes magazine named him one of Africa's top 10 young power men in 2011. Number 10, Vusi Tembekwayo, Magro Fund. Vusi Tembekwayo is the founder and CEO of Magro Fund, a South African venture capitalist firm with investment across the African continent. He is also the author of the Magna Carta of Exponentiality, his first book, and a business mogul who has developed and transformed companies in South Africa and abroad. Vusi Tembekwayo has always been a doer and a deep thinker with a continental lens. He founded a prosperous consultancy company at the age of 21, which was South Africa's first black-owned forensic marketing agency at the time. He was the youngest director of a listed company which has an annual turnover of $1.3 billion at the age of 25. But what we touch the most about Vusi is his ability to inspire and motivate when he stands on the podium. He believes strongly in Africa's future, and as he says very often, all that Africa needs from us is a little bit of faith. We are at the end of our video, but we don't want you to go like that. Let us have a convo in the comment section. Do you think Africa needs its entrepreneur to focus more on urgent needs like a better health system, good road network, or have a much technology and digitalization focus? We would love to hear from you. Make sure you also subscribe before you leave. See you next time. Bye-bye.